In the serene Massacre Rock State Park near Pocatello, Idaho, an eerie legend lurks, the Idaho water babies of Massacre Rocks. These spectral beings are said to haunt the Snake River, and their origins is shrouded in a tragic tale. The Snake River flows through Massacre Rocks and is believed to be a hotspot for paranormal activity. Legend has it that the river is haunted by water babies, spirits of drowned babies. The story varies, but a common theme is that, during a harsh famine, Native Americans or white settlers in the 1800s faced food scarcity. Mothers, unable to feed more mouths, supposedly had to drown their newborns in the river. According to the legend, these drowned babies transformed, growing fins and gills to survive in the water. Some claim to have seen these water spirits playing in canals and rivers in the Massacre Rocks area. It's even said that these spirits try to lure humans to meet a similar fate, seeking revenge for their tragic ends. Despite the beauty and history of Massacre Rocks, it's uncertain if the sad legend is true. Still, if you venture near the river, you might catch the distant sound of a baby crying for its mother. The well-to-hell legend originated in the 1990s, claiming that Russian scientists drilled a deep hole in Siberia, specifically on the Kola Peninsula. According to the story, the drill reached an astounding depth of around 9 miles or 15 kilometers or more. As the drill bit broke through the final layer, the legend suggests that the scientists experienced a sudden and extreme increase in temperature. At this supposed deepest point, the temperature allegedly soared to an unimaginable degree, causing the drill bit to melt. In addition to the extreme heat, the scientists claim to have heard horrifying sounds that were interpreted as the screams of tormented souls. The legend often takes on a religious overtone, with some versions referencing biblical passages and interpreting the event as the discovery of a gateway to hell or the underworld. Walking Sam, also called Tall Man or Stovepipe Hat Bigfoot, is described as a 7-foot-tall figure with eyes but no mouth, sometimes spotted wearing a stovepipe hat. When he lifts his arms, one can see the bodies of previous victims hanging beneath. When teenagers hear his calls, he tries to convince them they're worthless, urging them to harm themselves. Some think he goes after younger people because they're more easily fooled by his tricks. Others believe he might not be intentionally harmful, but rather someone who roams the woods as a form of punishment, seeking companionship. There are also connections to boogeyman stories and Slenderman myths. Looking at it from a cryptozoological perspective, some speculate he could be another version of, or somehow linked to, Bigfoot. Lastly, for a community with a strong spiritual bond to the land and their heritage, some see Walking Sam as a physical embodiment of the pain and trauma that Lakota Indians regularly endure. As the mystique surrounding Walking Sam persists, the legend weaves together elements of horror, folklore, and cultural symbolism, leaving those who delve into its narratives to grapple with the complexities of the unknown. Mngwa, a mythical creature rooted in Swahili folklore, is often depicted as a formidable feline inhabiting the East African region. Descriptions vary, but common attributes include a large and powerful build, resembling a giant leopard or lion, with a distinctive striped or spotted coat. Legends suggest it may be a nocturnal creature, prowling the night with stealth and elusiveness, emitting a fearsome roar that can be heard from a great distance. In Swahili folklore, the Mngwa is not merely a creature of physical prowess. It is also associated with supernatural realms and spiritual significance. Some stories portray it as a guardian or a being with mystical abilities, adding layers of mystery and intrigue to its character. While the Mngwa is widely considered a mythical being, some cryptozoologists have drawn connections between it and other large cat-like cryptids reported in different parts of the world. The Dobhar-chu is a mythical creature in the Irish folklore that captures the imagination with its enigmatic and mysterious nature. Revered as the water hound or water dog, this legendary being is often described as a formidable creature, reminiscent of an otter but possessing a distinct blend of dog and fish-like features. Tales of the Dobhar-chu have been passed down through generations, adding a touch of mystique to the cultural heritage of Ireland. The creature's reputation precedes it, with stories highlighting its remarkable speed and aggression, particularly in aquatic environments. According to the lore, encounters with the Dobhar-chu were fraught with danger, as the creature was said to be capable of swift and deadly attacks. Its habitat of choice was often lakes or bodies of water, where it would emerge to confront unsuspecting individuals. One of the most infamous tales involving the Dobhar-chu revolves around the tragic fate of Grace Connolly in the 17th century. As the legend goes, Connolly was engaged in the mundane task of washing clothes by the edge of a lake when the Dobhar-chu, lurking beneath the surface, launched a sudden and fatal assault. The creature claimed its victim and just as swiftly vanished back into the depths of the lake.